We see worry come up in our kids in a lot of different ways, which is why it's so important to be a student of our kids so we know who they are and how they typically behave so we can notice changes in their behavior.
Yeah, and sometimes depending on the child, it'll manifest itself in different ways. Yeah. For example, you know, your child might have seen, it might have come from a news source. It might have come from another friend talking about a particular accident that happened. So for example, let's just say that your child saw in the news or heard from a friend that there was a recent car accident that somebody was in. They might ask a lot of questions. Mom, Dad, can that happen to us? And now all of a sudden they get in the car and they're asking all kinds of questions. They're making sure everybody's seatbelt is on. They're making sure the airbags are turned on, and they're asking all kinds of questions. This is normal for children. Where it becomes abnormal over time is if months later, they're still obsessing about a car accident.
Yeah, another way it could become defiance. It could look disrespectful. And it's almost like, if you think what worry feels like in our own bodies, it's like a sense of agitation. We get really worked up inside, but a child doesn't know how to communicate that, and they certainly don't know healthy ways to get it out. So it may come out in agitation, disrespect, or defiance towards our parents.
Yeah, and I think the defiance and the disrespect piece is that front emotion. It's that thing that's manifesting itself. It's at the front end. It's like it's rearing its ugly head. But one of the things that we do is we get out a feelings chart, mm-hmm. and we just ask our kids to point to another emotion that they might be feeling, whether it's embarrassed or rejected, or they hit worry, right? And we simply ask the question, where did this start, or did something happen that caused this emotion? Can you remember? Can you talk about it? And just asking questions and following your child's lead, because a lot of times what ends up happening is they're feeling it in their body. And over time, you might see worry start to manifest itself if they're still feeling this in headaches. Maybe they're not sleeping at night, maybe they're not eating, or another physical manifestation that isn't otherwise seen from a medical illness. There's no reason that they would be feeling this other than it linking back to their emotion. And so what you wanna do is you wanna use a feelings chart to be able to help them label their emotion. The biggest mistake we can make as parents when it comes to worry with our kids is minimizing it, dismissing it, or even punishing the negative emotion. We want to, in the long run, get them to be able to talk about what it is they're feeling. Those other ways might suppress it in the moment, but what's gonna happen is it's gonna manifest itself later in the long run. So as parents, we wanna show up for our kids emotionally available, emotionally safe for them to be able to have a place that they can share their worries with us.